Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello student. Welcome to Vastech channel. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. Today I will explain the next experiment, that is the fifth experiment of 18 CSL 48 syllabus of VTU for the fourth semester CS and IS students. The experiment name is write a assembly language program to find out a square of a number in ARM LPC 2148 kit. So this is the algorithm and this is the program. Directly we will move to the program. As I explained in my previous video, the program starts with the TTL. TTL indicates the title of the program followed by area where we write the program, and the program file refers to the it is nothing but label given to the particular area, and this area is code only, and it is mapped to read only memory, and a program starts with the entry line. Now here you can see register R0 is loaded with the address of the lookup table, R1 is loaded with the value, R2 is loaded with the address of the result. Three things you have to see first. So what is there in the lookup table? So here you can see we have defined two separate areas. One is for both are for data. One stores the value and other stores the square of all the numbers from 0 to 10, and that is called as lookup table. So here you can see this is the lookup table which contains square of all numbers, that is square of 0 is 0, 1 is 1, 2 is 4, 3 is 9, like this till 10. And the name of the memory location is lookup, and it is a defined constant data, means 4 bytes of memory, and it is aligned with the 4 bytes boundaries, and the value is the value for which we want to find out the square is this one, number 9, that is also DCD type. Then result is stored in one more location. The name of the location is result, and it is also defined constant data, that means 4 bytes alignment. Now here, first the address of the lookup table is loaded in R0, value is loaded in R1, result is address of the result is loaded in R2. Now move R1 to R1 only, but before moving, some of the modification will be done here. That is, R1, the value in the R1 will get left shifted by two numbers. What is there in the R1? You see here, R1 actually contains value 9. You can see here value is mapped to, that address is mapped to R1, 9. So let me write here first. Number 9 in binary, if you write the number 9, 1001, let me extend this also, 000 and one more 0, so that I will take 1 byte number. So let me rewrite once again, 000 1001 001. So now here, what we are doing here is LSL. LSL by 2 bit. That means I am moving this entire number by to the left by 2 bits. That time, this will get shifted by 2 bits and this will get shifted by 2 bits. Okay. That time this becomes 0 0 1 0 0 1, and from the left side 0 moves. So now what is the value of this number? We know binary positional value. So the positional value of this one is 8, and this one is 4, and this one is 2, and this one is 1, right? This is 16, this is 32. So now what is the value of the number 32 and 4? That means 36. Now I have moved the value 36 to R1. R1 is 36. Why the value R1 is why I have moved the value 36 to R1, you will come to know later. But for timing, R1 is 32. Okay. Now after that, add R0 with R1. R0 is a lookup table address. Think like lookup table is a this one address is 4000. Think like this. Just imagine 4000. For that, R1 is added. Now this becomes a 4036, right? 4036. Now 4036. So R1 is added with the lookup table and it is stored in R0. R0 is a 4036. Now from this address, the value is moved to R3. That is, from this location, whatever value is there, that is moved to R3. You see here the logic. So I said address is 4036, and I said starting address is 4000, right? You remember lookup table starting address is 4000. This is a lookup table starting address 4000. Now each data, define constant data means 4 bytes. That means this will take 4 bytes. Now here it is 4000. Then from this point, it becomes 4004, 4008, something like this. 4012, so 4016, 4020, 4024, 28, 32, and 36. This value it will load. So what is the square of 81? We got 81. So this value will be loaded to that particular register. Which register? Let me go back. Which register it is loaded? It is loaded to register R3. Now R3 is stored in R2. R2 is the address here. You see, anything in the bracket indicates address. So what is there in R2? Result location. Result location is there in R2. So R3 is loaded in the result location. In this way, this program works. Let's go back to the kill version and we'll see. So the program is already loaded here. You can see already loaded. Project is already opened and you know how to open the project. Let me directly execute this program. Zero errors. This one. Oh, then debug session. It will start debug session. So let me execute the program at once. So this one. Now you can see the value is loaded in R3 register. The value in R3 register is 51. So you can see here our program window. You can see R3 contains the value. R3 contains value, and that value is loaded into memory location R2. First we'll verify the value is correct or not. R3 is 51. Let me open the calculator. So 81 in decimal, hexadecimal, it becomes 51. Same value is stored in a memory. Memory is indicated by R2. So let me open memory window. Once again, sometimes it will not open. So click on the same thing. So here type 0x4000, so 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, enter, and you can see here the result 51 is stored. In this way you can execute this experiment. If you need feedback, please force the feedback in the comment section. Thank you. Bye bye.